Destroy.
Hello and welcome to this October 10th edition of Off the Map Live. I am your host, Ben Licata. Welcome to the show. It's not too late to share this with your friends on Facebook and join us in the chat room if you like. This show is brought to you by the Paradise Tattoo Gathering, which is happening next week, a week from this Thursday. All schedules are up. You can buy your seminar tickets. And in this coming week, we'll have online webinar sales for most of the seminars that are available in person. So if you can't make it there, if you're too far away, you can get it online. Also brought to you by Reinventing the Tattoo, now a digital app. The book's out of print, but you can now get the updated app, which is updated regularly, has guest chapters and videos. It's really an invaluable resource for anyone who's trying to push their tattoo career a little bit further. Brought to you by Dax McClellan's Realistic Portrait System. Check out tattooingportraits.com and get Dax's take on tattooing realistic portraits. We are also brought to you by Voluta Digital. They are the makers of the Tattoo Release Form app, which we use here in the studio. It saves a lot of paper, saves a lot of time. Once your client fills out the information on an easy, very, user-friendly iPad, they don't have to fill it out again. When they come back, they can look up their name. All their information is there. You don't have to store file cabinets full of paper. It's a great tool. We've been using it for over a year now, and it's been really awesome. And last but not least, Off the Map Tattoo, where we're coming to you live from right now at the new Majestic Theater in East Hampton, Massachusetts, where we just happen to have a Guy Aitchison and Adam France dual art show going on, Surface and Space. The opening was just this past weekend, so the art is up. You can come check it out and take home a beautiful original piece of artwork by Guy Aitchison or Adam France. Adam France also has his new Protoscience sketchbook available. You can get it here, or you can go to Adam's website. It's beautifully bound, awesome silver leaf edges. It's truly an amazing look into Adam's artwork, and it's a two-piece set. So one is Adam's sketchbook, and the other one is a beautifully bound blank one for you to put your ideas into. Like I said, we have them here at the studio, or you can go to Adam's website and pick yourself one up. They're limited. There's only 300, so they won't be around forever. On this episode, we have Ralph Nonweiler coming in via Skype from Germany, and off-the-map resident Gao Feng. He looks nervous. Gao, you nervous? Oh, no, he says he's all right. So we'll be talking with Ralph and Gal in a little bit. Our next episode will be coming to you live from Jiminy Peak during setup next Monday with David Corden and Chris Jones. So you won't get to see this beautiful backdrop. Hopefully we'll have some nice scenery for you to see. And we'll be talking with David Corden and Chris Jones. If you missed any of our episodes, you can go to our YouTube channel and check out 3 years worth of interviews. We've got people like Oliver Peck, Hannah Aitchison, Teresa Sharp, Corey Ferguson, Jesse Smith, BJ Betts, Jess Yen, Jeff Gogway, I don't know, a million other people. Speaking of Jeff Gogway, he was on our last show with Marcus Lenhard. That should be up on our iTunes store and YouTube for you to check out. If it's not up now, it'll be up soon. It's now available in video and audio format, so you can take it anywhere. There's no excuse not to check it out. And if you like what you see or hear, review it. We need some more ratings. We've got to get ourselves out there and get more people watching and listening. We will be right back after these couple ads with Ralph Nonweiler. So stick around. We'll see you after these commercials.
At whatever stage you may be in your tattoo career, apprentice, experienced street shop tattooer, or fully custom artist, it's hard not to feel a little competitive in today's tattoo industry, with so many amazing artists working in all styles in virtually every corner of the world. But you can benefit right now by learning from the experience of the tattoo professionals who have dedicated themselves to education in this industry. I'm Guy Aitchison, and I've been teaching in the tattoo field for much of my 27 years in the trade. with most of my educational efforts being focused within my Reinventing the Tattoo platform, which has been an industry standard in education for nearly two decades. Reinventing was originally conceived as a series of seminars that I held at tattoo conventions, and its curriculum has been filled out and fine-tuned according to the needs of the artists attending these classes. It's now a massive standalone educational package which can be viewed on any kind of device in order to bring the answers you need right to your fingertips. The Reinventing the Tattoo curriculum is centered around a group of fundamental artistic principles of composition, including flow and fit on the body, contrast, positive-negative relationships, color theory, depth, and other concepts, which are framed in a way that's meant to be as useful as possible to working tattoo artists. The material then covers uses of reference imagery and digital tools in your design process, along with a review of alternate art forms such as oils and watercolors and how they can help refine your skills as a tattoo artist. The technical sections are as comprehensive as possible, covering everything from machines and other basic equipment to stenciling and working on various challenging parts of the body. Not only am I sharing everything useful that I know about these subjects, but I'm also enlisting the help of various top-name professionals, such as Russ Abbott, Nick Baxter, Megan Jean Morris, Phil Garcia, Halo Jankowski, and Don McDonald to share their own experience on these topics. You may have already read the book version of Reinventing the Tattoo. However, the new electronic edition has been seriously updated and expanded beyond the scope of the old book, including not only new chapters by myself and our guest writers, but also introducing a massive section on cover-up tattooing, including chapters on lasers and scar cover-ups, plus loads of new video footage to further illustrate the book's topics. Subscribers can look forward to seeing new material added regularly along with further updates to existing content as the Reinventing curriculum continues to expand and evolve. I'd like to invite you to drop by reinventingthetattoo.com to read more about what we have to offer in the Reinventing the Tattoo educational package. It's the biggest and most detailed teaching effort I've ever been involved with, and I'm completely confident that no matter where you stand in your tattoo career, it can help you to take your work to the next level.
About now. Hey, Ralph.
Hey.
Hey, what's that ding?
You hear me?
Yeah, man. Is that text messages that you keep getting? Ding.
No, I don't have one.
No, that's okay. So for people who don't know you, can you tell me a little bit about your story?
Oh, God, my story. It's how I became a tattoo artist or about myself, what's going on at the moment, or
all right,
you want to know?
Let's start in the beginning. How did you get interested in art?
Oh my God. I was, I was 3 years of age, and I was always painting when I went out, for example, with my parents, and I had always a ruler, and I was painting on the paper towels in a restaurant, and maybe, for example, my father, he painted me something like a letter, and I made some like an animal out of it, I was always interested in doing portraits and stuff like that, and yes, and my father was always interested in keep me going into painting and drawing and stuff like that, and yeah, that's how it began. And in school I was always painting while school or while mathematics, and that's how it all started. And I was always interested in faces and nature, not into maybe too graphical stuff. And I think the most important influence was at the end of my school when I got into airbrush. I was introduced into this airbrush stuff, and then I was really, really focused on airbrushing faces and skulls, and that's how it all started. And some years later, I had the first contact with tattooing, and then for some years I stopped. I wasn't interested in it, and when I came back to my hometown, I met a friend, and he had really bad tattoos, and that's how it started. And now I'm here, and happy to start to have started tattooing for six or seven years now.
So
that's how all started.
So tattooing has afforded you the opportunity to travel a lot, right?
Yeah, that's right. And this year I was so lucky to get to the New York convention and to bring my whole family with me, so I could work. I was working at Lalo as a guest spot, and I was working for one day at Paul Booth. He's one of my biggest heroes, and it was a huge honor to work at these both shops and to get new influence while my people, my daughters and my wife went to New York. They go to Central Park and feed the squirrels while I was working at those shops and met new people. I could show my family New York, and that's perfect. I was at London Convention, I think it was two weeks ago, and I brought my whole family with me, and yes, they can go out, they can go and see London, and that's awesome. That's just awesome. So,
how was your experience?
It makes it a lot. Sorry?
How was your experience in London at the convention itself?
It was amazing for me. Yeah, it's a great show, and the organization and everything around, it's just perfect. It's so well organized, and it's, for me, it's one of the best shows on this planet. So, because you know, you go there, you meet such a lot of people, and it's just also the environment, the tobacco dock where it took place. It's just an amazing building with it's bright, and I like it. I was there for some years just as a visitor, and then I had the opportunity to go with you guys at the Off the Map booth last year. It was my first time working on the show. And and this year I shared the booth together with Alex DePaza, and it was just awesome. It's a huge honor for me to work there, and yeah, hopefully you guys come back next year.
Yeah, I'm sure we will.
Who
are you inspired by? Are you inspired by other tattooers or other artists that are outside of the tattoo world?
Yes, of course. When I started painting, you get a lot of influence by H.R. Giger. This is how I started with those airbrush stuff. I think a lot of people start, when they do airbrush, they focus on Giger. Or I had a lot of influence by Boris Vallejo and his wife Julie Bell. I met an exhibition together with them, and on this exhibition there was also Renato Cassaro, the guy who made some movie posters for Rambo or stuff like that, and Misery, he painted all those posters. And you know, when you exhibit with those people, it just pushes you. And in the tattoo scene, of course, I had a lot of help from Alex DePaza. He helped me so much. And when I saw his work, I was so inspired, and I was pushed by his work. I, of course, had a lot of influence by Bob Tyrell. When I saw his black and gray portraits, this is just, for me, it was just amazing. And this just keeps me going. Those guys, they are such a huge inspiration for all of us, I think. And when I had the opportunity to get in contact, especially with Alex, it was a huge influence. He gave me so much tips, and that's amazing. If you meet those people, I think a lot of people, they should go out and talk to those guys and ask questions, the same that I did. I just send a lot of pictures of my tattoos to different people, and that's how it all started. And I met those people, and I went to conventions, looked what they were doing, and that's just, I think this is the best way to start.
Speaking of Bob Tyrell, you did, you were here for Black and Gray Week last year, and you tattooed Bob. How was that experience?
Man, I even think about that while I'm tattooing, maybe last week, because, you know, this was such a huge inspiration. I was so nervous, you know. He's one of my heroes, and I was shaking. I was so nervous putting on the stencil, and it just hit with the first in the first time. So I just put it on, and it was nice. And I was so afraid of have to put on the stencil two or three times, but I was lucky that it just stick. In the first time, so I was not so nervous anymore, but the problem was, you know, I tattooed Bob on the back of his upper leg, mm-hmm. and I was thinking, okay, when I can do the tattoo on this part, he is not able to watch what I'm doing, but he was lying on his belly, and you know that just in front of him there was the monitor. Uh-huh. And he could watch the whole thing, and you did the zoom, and I was, you know, I was, oh no, now he can watch every single needle stitch, and that was it. But I think after half an hour it was okay, so I just did my thing, and I think it turned out okay. So, but I had the opportunity at Big Gus's shop to do 1 hour more on just some touch-ups and go into the black, and I think it was okay. It was a huge experience. So for me, it was, you know, when you are tattooing your hero, it's, I think, everybody who's into portraits or portrait tattooing, it's one of the biggest honors you can achieve, that Bob is wants to have a tattoo done by you. So
that tattoo that you did on Bob was also the very first time I ever tattooed a person.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah. Do you remember?
Yeah. So, yeah, I remember. I remember your handshake when you said, oh, you will start tattooing, and I think you kept your word. And now you're into tattooing, and I heard that you were tattooing before we made this call, and that makes me happy.
Yeah,
that's nice. Yeah,
because of that handshake that I made with you and Bob on the street after that tattoo.
Yeah, I remember that, and I think it was worth it. You know, you're a great guy, and you should do more. You should. I like that. And hopefully next year when I come back, you will do a small skull just to remember it.
Of course.
On my leg, if you like. It would be great.
That would be wonderful.
You know? Yeah, for me. You know?
Hey, I've got a question from the chat room. They want to know what kind of machine you're using for your black and gray stuff.
I'm together with Stigma. And for me, I tried all the machines from Stigma, from the Hyper. I tried the Bizarre. And the machines that I use the most are the Bizarre for round shaders and the line work. I don't do too much lines, but for making details on the eyes, eyelashes, and stuff like that, working on between the spaces of the teeth. And but for shading, it's my favorite machine is just the Brodigy. So because I can use bigger Magnum groupings, and I work with the Brodigy from 7 mag to 17 mag, and I work with the Beast. It's also a Stigma, and I use a 10 watts motor plug. Just for using bigger mags, for example, 25 needles just to put in or to cover large areas of skin. So these are the machines that I use the most.
So
I also use the Hyper for making small shadings with 7 mag. That's what I'm using.
What are you using for blacks, for inks these days?
I work only with Pantera. I use the whole range they produce, from the triple X over the black. They have a dark and a light Sumi, and they asked me for doing like an artist series. But I just talked to Ruggiero. He's the inventor of the Pantera ink. And I told him, I love your set. I would prefer, instead of doing a whole artist series, just to add 2 tones to his range he already had. And so I did my blending and the finish. And for example, with the blending I did, it's just for if you have light shadings, for example, on the forehead, you can use this ink just to sculpt in the lightest areas. But I use Pantera.
So how important is the equipment that you're using compared to like your technique or your vision of your ideas? Like, how do they compare?
I think that it's just like when I did the airbrush, I just focused on one airbrush. Because I knew for me this worked the best, so I could just focus on my work. I didn't have to think about the technique anymore, and I just focused on those Stigma machines, because you know when I feel safe and secure with those machines, I just can focus on my work. So I don't have to think. In the beginning, I was using coil machines. I tried a lot of different types of machines. But when I got in contact with Petra from Stigma and Artemis, I was happy that they asked me to use their machines and to get used to their machines. And so I stick with it, and I said, okay, I stay with together with them, and I still have the opportunity to work with them on new designs or new machines, and so I just can focus on I have my setup, and I think it's really important if you found your setup to stick with it, because then if you just stick with it and if you don't look around too much, you just can focus on making the tattoo last, to make the details last in the skin. Because I think that a lot of tattoo artists, they play too much. And at the moment, I see a lot of tattoos that are great. But I think it's important to make the ink stay in the skin over years, and this is what I'm working on at the moment, just to make all the details last in the skin. It's easy to tattoo a nice piece, to grab a photo for Instagram with nice shadings, with a lot of water. It looks nice for Instagram, but it doesn't look nice for the customers in 2 years. And I think this is the most important thing that I'm working on. So I rely on my machines, on my setup, on my needles. I use Magic Moon needles, and I found my setup, and I think this is the most important thing, to feel comfortable. Yeah.
Have you experimented at all with the Stigma rotary machine, the pen thing that they were working on?
They are just working on it, and I had a prototype, and I think hopefully they will finish it in the next month. But it's like Artemis, he always wants to make it as good as he can, so he prefers to go out with it when it's just perfect. I used the cartridges before, and I they are amazing, because I like the needles that I use, but it's the design that they use for their cartridges, it's just something completely new, that because now you can use a pen or their pen like a normal pencil. And this is nice. This was a good idea that he had, and I prefer that he waits until it's just perfect. Because I think a lot of people, they have an idea and they throw it on the market, but if you work with it, you feel maybe here and there they could have done more. And this is what I like about Stigma. They think and they try and I like the pen, but I think it will take 2 or 3 months more until they come out with it.
Right. Hey, so you're coming back here next July, right, for the Global Tattoo Realism Summit?
Yes. It's a huge honor for me, and I want to thank Gabe and you guys that I'm able to host this event. And I'm really looking forward to it. I'm thinking about it every single day, what we can offer to those artists that will attend the summit. And I think it's going to be a really great experience for me and to exchange. And hopefully we can do something completely new that's interesting for the people. And maybe we have the chance to talk again over Skype and to have maybe some ideas by the viewers, what they want to have or what they want to experience with this summit.
Absolutely.
And because this would be nice to collect some ideas, what would be interesting for the people that are out there, what they wanted to know or they want to know. Alex DePaz is coming, Steve Butcher, Bob Tyrell, it's Matteo Pasqualin. It's a lot of input and a lot of great artists. And maybe if a lot of people will write to you guys, we can make a great event out of it.
Yeah, I think that would be wonderful. We'll definitely get some feedback forms out there for everybody to get in contact
Hopefully.
With us. Yeah, we've got plenty of time before that happens, so we'll definitely reach out to everybody and get their opinions for sure.
That would be nice. Yeah.
Have you ever taken an apprentice?
Yeah. I have my Patrick, and this will be the first and the last apprentice that I will ever take, because I in the beginning I was afraid to take an apprentice, because when I got into this tattoo scene, I had some problems because no one told me nothing, but I had, like I said before, I had a lot of help by Alex, and I was afraid to take some under my wings and to help him and to guide him, and because I was just thinking maybe this guy comes into the shop and he stays there for 1 year and then he will leave and open his own shop. Because I met this guy named Tom Schmidt. He's from Germany. And this is the guy that showed me a lot. He was my master. And he told me a lot about this honor that there should be in this tattoo scene, about not if you have a master, that you don't open a shop 2 streets besides of the shop of your master. And I was afraid of that, because I tell Patrick a lot of stuff and that I figured out over the years for myself, and I was afraid to share this knowledge with him. But he's a great guy, and he developed so well, and I feel so happy with this guy that I said to myself, this will be the first person and the last person that I will ever give an apprenticeship. You know, because it's a lot of energy you put into giving your knowledge and to talk to your apprentice. And, you know, I have 4 kids and so I like it. And I think it was I was so lucky with Patrick. I was so happy that this will be the last experiment like this. So he's still with me and we are still happy together, and hopefully it stays a lot of more years.
How do you find a balance between having an apprentice and having four children and being married and traveling? How do you find a good balance?
I don't know. Look at me. You know, I don't know. This week I have off. Normally I have off from the shop, and at the moment I'm on vacation. But you know, I was in the shop today for maybe 2 hours because I'm at home, and I think the best way is to get away, just to go on vacation, to travel to a different country. Because if you stay at home, you know, you will go to the shop, or you give a call to Patrick in the shop, how is it going, or you answer some emails and stuff like that. And it's hard because every of our daughters, I have four daughters, they are all doing sports. And for example, Hannah, she trains 6 times a week, Lily trains 7 times a week, Bella just started playing tennis 2 times or 3 times a week. And you know, I in the morning I go to the shop, I do my tattoo, I talk to the clients, then I jump in the car, go to the training, then I drive home, take Lily to the other training, then I go home, answer some questions or emails, check out some references, and next day it goes on. And on the weekend it's, you know, there is a tournament or stuff like that. And if you have I'm married since a long time, and for my wife and me it's really, really hard to have some time together. It's nearly not possible, you know. While I'm sitting here talking to you, she's in the bedroom sleeping. And yes, I wanted to stay awake for this event tonight, and so we played Monopoly until 12 a.m. Or midnight. And now we have 1:45 in the morning, and I'm still awake. And, you know, it's hard. It's really hard. But I think it's important to give yourself always a challenge every day, just to... yeah, to make a new challenge, to focus on your work. And that's why I said to myself, I just stick together with Patrick, work with guest artists, and not to have residents. Because I think for me it would be too much stress to deal with different characters. So, you know it by yourself. I had Max Rothart,
yes,
from Off the Map, East Hampton, for 1 week, and this was such a nice experience for me. You guys should all check out this guy. He's a wonderful person. He's a great artist, and this was what I want to offer to my people, to my customers, that I have more guest artists from far away. Maybe someday you will come over and work in my shop, or... that would be nice. And
next year
I will have Matteo. I hopefully will have Bob. I will have Pat German working in my shop. And so it's nice. It's a nice idea just to work with guest artists, because you can offer your clients a lot of different things in your shop. Because I'm focused on portraits or realistic stuff. Patrick is doing his cartoon style or comic style. And when, for example, you had Max, he's great in doing realistic stuff, but maybe in another way that I'm doing it. So it's nice. It's nice for my clients. And this is what I want to offer to the people.
Have you ever thought about doing color work, or are you going to stick with black and gray?
Yes, I was just thinking about doing color, but you know, I will definitely... I was talking to Alex about this topic, but I will definitely stick with black and gray, because it's... I think even in one lifetime, it's impossible to fulfill every aspect of black and gray, because you can experience so much things every day to try different needles groupings or to see how it heals. And when I would start doing color now, it's a complete new country for me, and so I prefer just to stay with the black and gray and do the and become the best that I can ever be in for myself in black and gray, and it's okay for me. I will definitely stick with black and gray. Maybe like I did in the last times, I just add some highlights with, for example, red or green or stuff like that. This is okay for me, and I know how to do that, but I wouldn't be able to work like, for example, Alex or all those other great guys that do beautiful color work. I prefer to stay away and let those guys do this work and focus on my black and gray.
How about large scale pieces? You know, have you thought about doing like full body pieces or back pieces?
Yeah, I just had I get some emails, and most of the time my wife is answering all the emails, and I have a lot of interest in doing some back pieces or a whole back piece, but I don't do back pieces, because I'm thinking in the way that, for example, like I said before, I have four children, and you will never know what will be in 3 years. And, you know, maybe it's interesting. I had cancer 11 years ago, and you will never know what will happen in the next year or in 2 years. I don't think about that the cancer will come back, but you never know what will happen. And if I would imagine that I will work on a whole back, and this will take a lot of time, and I had to stop, for example, with tattooing because something will happen, and I feel guilty because I of course you will finish it, and if I cannot finish the whole bag, I cannot tell to my customer you have to go to someone else. So I prefer to just doing maybe an arm or a leg, something like this, and stick with this kind of stuff and not doing large scale pieces. I will stay away from this.
Okay. So what are your travel plans for the rest of the year?
I don't know. I was thinking of going over to the US in December, but you know, like we talked before, at the moment I have a lot of things to do because I'm in vacation now, and I work on my house at home. And we decided to work on our bathroom, and it's so much stuff to do. And I was thinking of spending the Christmas holidays in the US, but the problem is my mother, she's alone, and we live together in one house, and I'm a little afraid of leaving her alone here in Germany, and because this would be the first time ever to leave her. So I think we will stay in Germany over Christmas. And the only thing that I want to do this year is going over to England and doing a video for Killer Inc.
Okay.
I was talking to Lace about that. And yes, this is what I want to do this year. This will be the last thing that I will do for sure. Wow. And for next year, there are some plans. And
so, before I let you go, if someone's interested in getting tattooed by you, how do they do that?
We have giving the appointments every 3 months. for 3 months. So we have on our website, we have something like a form that you can fill out. You can attach some JPEGs or the stuff that you're interested in. And this will send an email to our website, and then we will check those mails, and we leave the server open for 12 hours, and then we will check what's not interesting, but you know, if there are some cover ups or back pieces, stuff like that that I don't do, we of course reply. And I check what I can do, what's the stuff that I'm doing, and then we get back to the people. We fill 3 months, and after those 3 months, we will open the website again, and the people, they can sign in again, and we get back to them. That's how it's, of course, but also a lot of people, they call us in the shop, or they just send us an email, or they ask over Facebook, and yeah, that's the easiest way, just to send an email or contact us over Facebook or Instagram.
All right. Well, Ralph, I really appreciate you talking with me and staying up late to do so.
Ben, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity, man.
And I'll definitely have you back. Sometime before next July, for sure.
Yes, hopefully. If it's possible that maybe some people, they send us some ideas what would be interesting for them in this summit, it would be nice if they sent you some emails or they contact you or me. Would be great just to do something different.
We'll make sure that we set up a way for people to contact us and give us a little bit of information, for sure.
Wow, that would be nice.
Thanks again, man. I will. I'll talk to you soon.
Get some
thank
sleep. Thank you, Ben. Oh yes, I will definitely do now.
All right, man. Talk to you later.
Okay, Ben. All right, okay, everyone. Bye.
Ralph Nonviler, everyone. A very tired Ralph Nonviler. If you lived his life, you would be tired too. 4 daughters. No thanks. After this commercial break, we'll be back with Gao Feng and the network news and all of that stuff. So stick around, and we'll be back in just a few minutes. See ya.
Tattoo artists are power creators, not power administrators.
Save time, money, and trees with Tattoo Release Forms app. Your client will photo his ID, enter personal information, information about the tattoo, health information, initial legal clauses, and sign his name. When the client is finished, you can make session notes and choose inks and needles from the most popular brands and configurations. Preview the form, sign it, and hit upload. The form lands on a secure cloud in seconds as a printable PDF. If you're at a convention or without Wi-Fi, TRF will automatically upload the forms next time you're online. Return clients can simply search for themselves, check to make sure all the information is correct, and sign again. Done in seconds. Download Tattoo Release Forms app from the Apple App Store for free and enjoy 25 free forms. Also available in the UK, Canada, and Australia.
We're back. Gao Feng, Gao, welcome to the show.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
I can't believe this is the first time you've been here.
Yeah, exactly. This is my first time talk on the stage.
How do you feel?
I feel nervous, but yeah? I'm very excited.
Good. So, Gao's a resident here. How long have you been with us?
I joined the Off the Map team since last August.
So over a year?
Yes.
How is it going?
Going great, man.
How did you end up here?
What you mean, end up here?
Yeah, at Off the Map. What made you want to work here?
Because when I first know American tattoo culture, it's already off the map. Already, it's a name out there, and it's in my heart. So when I saw off the map, have the notice, want to try new artist, so I can beginning to talk with them.
So where did tell me about a little bit about where you spent your childhood and how you got into tattooing. So start that way.
My childhood, my childhood is totally different with American people.
Right.
Yeah, because I live in a very traditional Chinese family. So, what do you mean the part of the childhood?
Well, was tattooing accepted in your family?
No. My family is, my mom is a doctor, and my stepfathers will do some kind of like the different business, but I'm the totally different. I play guitar and I do tattooing. It's kind of like a strange guy in my family.
You're the black sheep. You're like the punk rock tattoo guy.
Yes.
How long have you been in the United States?
I have been here almost 4 years. Yeah. I started coming to the States. I live in Georgia for a while, and I moved to New Hampshire, the up north, because my wife continued her education. And right at that time, I worked in a few different shops, and I saw off the map. So I gonna send the email, and I'm very lucky they accept me to come to be the guest spot. And I just come here to connect with you guys. Keep going and going until now I sit here.
And now you're here.
Right.
Were you tattooing in China?
Oh, yes.
How did you begin?
After my art college, and right that second I play my band a lot, and I don't know where's my future, and because rock music make me touch the tattoo, because right that second I have a music friend who started doing the tattooing.
Okay.
And because of him, I started really into this stuff. And think about that, I love it, why not to do it? So I just tell myself, I want to be a tattoo artist.
How did you learn to tattoo?
I learned tattoo under Zhen Chang Ciqing. Shaogang. I learned it under him in Shanghai, yeah, which is a few years ago.
What was your apprenticeship like? Did you have a traditional apprenticeship? Did you have to make needles and things like that?
Actually, I don't make needles. One thing I'm doing the tattooing, it's use the regular needles with tubes.
Sure.
Yes.
When you were apprenticing, what kind of tattoos were you doing?
I do a lot of American traditional work, and I basically do customer whatever you want, and I try to bring my own idea in it and show it to you.
Cool.
Yes.
So do you specialize in any style tattoo now?
I call it Asia style. Japanese traditional, Chinese traditional, it's basic from a lot from the Buddha religion, and some old Chinese things. It's kind of like the dragon, it's the very biggest the Chinese symbol, like a dragon phoenix, lot kind of koi. Yeah, my idea, a lot of my idea is from the old Chinese lining painting.
Oh yeah, cool.
Yes.
You really enjoy tattooing in that style?
Oh yes, I really enjoy that. I like to do the big scale work, like a whole arm, kind of like full chest, something like that. Because I feel that kind of tattoo can give people power feeling, can give people, when they look at it, they can really into it. So like a clean line work, bold color.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've seen some of your dragon tattoos are pretty cool, man. I really like them a lot. So we do Tai Chi here every week.
Oh, yes.
You do it a lot more than the rest of us do. How does that help?
I feel artists, we sit all the time. We keep the same position all the time, every day. Doesn't matter you stand there or you just sit out there. You not move too much. And I feel important is talk about Tai Chi, it's Qi. How about the Qi in the flow to go through in your body, and you use this time to move your whole body to point the Qi, make them matching each other, that is definitely help. So
I think it helps. I like it a lot.
Yeah.
How's your experience been trying to teach all of us?
I feel that's a great experience. You guys are really rock. So you guys learn it really, really fast. And we're going to continue to doing that. I'm really enjoying to play that with you guys.
I like it too. It's a lot of fun.
Yes.
You've got quite a bunch of tattoos.
Oh, yes.
Who are some of the people that you artists that you have collected tattoos from?
I get the new list. My special one is from Bob Terry.
Oh,
it's,
yes.
It's a skull tattoo. It's on my forearm. This is really...
Let's see it.
You want to see it?
Yeah, yeah. All right. We'll zoom that camera out a little. This way. Mm-hmm. Right there. All right, stay still. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's rad.
You like it?
I love it.
It's okay, huh?
Yeah. I really love it.
I know,
I'm
joking.
It's my best skull tattoo on me so far.
It's amazing. When did that happen?
Bob Terry, he wanted to make a video. And you introduced us to meet together. And
right.
That was special things happening.
Yeah. We're filming a video on how he tattoos his skulls for an upcoming DVD, and that's how you got that one.
I really wanted to see it. It's kind of like
the video?
Kind of special feeling to myself in the video.
Well, we're releasing his dog video next week at Paradise, so we're going to have to wait another year before you can see your skull DVD.
I can't wait.
You can wait?
Yeah.
I think it's going to be good. If you didn't catch that, Bob's new DVD premieres at Paradise. It's all about dog fur and textures and stuff. And then you can wait and get this next skull one. It'll be cool. So I hear that you might be collaborating with Jeff Gogwe.
Yeah, that's such a great experience. It's not happening yet, but it's a great experience to me because he said that.
What do you hope to learn from that experience?
I hope to learn how to set up the perfect flow to the big scales work. You know, big scales work, kind of like the whole body suit. In my opinion, my favorite stare is simple, but everything is perfect. Everything is correct, clean, and land at there, the flow, it's why the flow gonna be curved a little bit, just a little small details gonna change everything. This is, I feel, the most important thing to learn.
So how did the idea of this collaboration come about? Like, how did this happen?
I think how it happened, I don't know yet.
No, I mean, how did you guys decide that you would do this? Did Jeff ask you?
Oh, yes. He bring this up, and I feel, oh, really? You want to do a tattoo with me? That's awesome. I tell myself, that's fucking great.
Absolutely.
Yes.
It's quite an honor. So, you have a big back piece, right?
Yes.
Who did it?
I got a dragon out of there.
Who did it?
Yes, my teacher.
Yeah? Do you want to show everybody what it looks like?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
It's a little shine through my back.
You want to? You don't have to.
Oh, yeah?
Gabe asked me.
Oh, you connect here?
Yeah, he writes right here. Maybe next time?
Maybe next time.
Okay. It's cool. I've seen it. It's really cool. Are you going to be tattooing at Paradise?
Yeah, I think so. I tried to take all my stuff, get there, and
see what happens.
Yeah, what I want to do is I try to take more seminars to learn more stuff from there.
Are there any seminars that you're looking to take in particular that you're interested in? Are there any that you're interested in?
Yeah, I'm interested in Bob Terry's seminar and Jeff Gogwe's new seminar.
Yeah, I want to sit in on Marcus Lenhard's one. It looks interesting. Elizabeth Courtney wants to know, she's from the chat room, how long have you been tattooing?
I have been tattooing over 8 years.
She wants a tattoo from you. How does she get one?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Come to Off the Map Tattoo.
That's true. You can send an email in through offthemaptattoo.com. Just go find Gao on there and look at his portfolio, and you can send an email right through there. Right?
Yes.
She says your work is amazing and loves your philosophy about what you bring to your work.
Thank you. I feel this is a great opportunity to show my work to more people, that they judge my work. I feel that's great. I can make more friends.
Have you been to many conventions?
The last convention I have been to is the Mass Convention in Winchester.
Oh yeah.
With Tim.
How was that experience?
That's good. That is a very nice convention, and I got some work done at there, and which is a sleeve, not able to finish it. But the next setting, I'm going to set up it very soon.
Oh, cool. And Tim's always fun to travel with.
Yes.
He's great.
He's great. Yeah.
He's great at conventions. Well, thanks very much for talking with me, man.
Oh, yes.
I appreciate it.
Yes.
Yeah, it's quick. See, time goes by really quickly.
Yes.
We want to know, do you do cover-ups?
Sorry, what's that?
Do you do cover-up tattoos?
Oh, yes, I do cover-up tattoos.
Do you find them challenging? Are they hard?
Sometimes they are very hard.
I've seen some of your cover-ups, and sometimes you cover them completely, and sometimes you work around them.
Oh, yes.
Which way do you prefer, or does it depend?
That's dependent. If I fear the cover-up, it's... my point is, I don't want one cover-up finish it, it's too dark. This is my point. If I can't cover up it, but the customer still keep wanting to do it, I will suggest that maybe you will like to do something around it. Maybe it's better, or I just let you, suggesting you to laser it
right
first. Yeah.
Cool. All right, man. That's it. That's
Thank
good.
Thank you so much again.
Thank you. I appreciate you coming.
Yeah.
Would you do it again now?
Yes, I can.
It's not so bad, right?
Yeah, not so bad.
No real need to be nervous. Mm-hmm. So everyone, Gaotong, what's your website?
My website is gaotattoo.com. Check it out, please.
Gaotattoo.com. You heard him. Check him out. Book an appointment today. We will be back after these commercial messages with the network news with Josh DeHosa. Stick around, it's going to be a good one, I'm sure. Right, Josh?
Okay.
He says it'll be all right, so stick around for that. See you in a bit.
What is a webinar? It's your chance to up your game and improve yourself with new techniques in art, in business, and tattooing. Webinars are streaming professional development seminars taught by the masters of their craft that you can watch in the comfort of your home, your studio, or even on the go on your mobile device. If you have a stable internet connection, you can stream a webinar. Here at Tattoo Now, we continually produce high-quality video presentations from top artists and business people. Our catalog includes hours of education from greats like Guy Aitchison, Bob Tyrell, DJ Betts, Jeff Gogway, Russ Abbott, James Kern, Tommy Helm, Ian McCowan, Kelly Doty, Remmer Oriana, and more all the time. These professional artists share their years of experience to accelerate your path and help you become more successful. Fill up on high-octane brain fuel now with the Tattoo Now webinar. Do you want to bring your career to the next level? Then webinars from Tattoo Now can help you do that.
So hey, it's October 10th, and we got some news for you. First, it's National Angel Food Cake Day. Woo! That is so boring and incredibly bland, so may your day be bland and boring. Also, I would like to wish a happy birthday to Dale Earnhardt Jr., Brett Favre, and David Lee Roth. The makers of cheap beer all across America would also like to thank you for your hard work and efforts. So good. Anyway, now we have some actual tattoo news. Paradise Gathering is coming up. Don't miss the Jade Effect, which is Laura Jade's new seminar. If you want, you can go to paradisetattoogathering.com and register for the seminar, along with all the other awesome seminars you can take. Parched. Also, Lucky Bamboo Tattoo is seeking a full-time resident artist. They're located in Utah. Check out luckybambootattoo.com. And Friday, October 14th at Off the Map in Grants Pass, Oregon, Jeff Gogway and Marcus Leonard are doing their seminars. Tickets can be purchased at tattoonow.com. That should be a pretty awesome bunch of seminars. You guys think so? Yeah? Awesome.
I would go if I was 3,000 miles from here.
Yeah. And then more awesome stuff. You can work at Darkwater.
What?
Darkwater Tattoo. Yeah. They're seeking a marketing assistant. So that's still pretty awesome because Jose and everybody there are super cool and it's a great opportunity. Darkwaterstudio.com for more information on that one. And then finally, we're just gonna, you know, have everybody in here come up for a second if they want. Hi, Ben.
What's up, man? I think we should zoom out a little.
We should probably zoom out.
That's up to Tim, though.
Well, I'm gonna start reading some stuff.
Okay.
So over the weekend, the tattoo industry lost a total legend, Philadelphia Eddie.
Oh, you see it? Okay, keep talking.
Yeah, Philadelphia Eddie. He passed away over the weekend. Anyone that ever had the opportunity to share a moment with Eddie knows the stories, and they know what an honor it was to have met him. So, you know, you get this world with like tattoo celebrities, social media, artist sponsorships, and competitions, and whatever. It's important to remember and respect and talk to those that made all of this possible, like Eddie. So we just want to thank Eddie for everything that he did for tattooing. So we're just gonna take a moment, raise our Malibus and pineapple.
Rest in peace.
And say thanks, Eddie.
Thanks, Eddie. Woo! Delicious.
That's so good. And we'll be back with Ben.
Okay.
We'll be back with Ben. We had to have someone. I like this shot.
At whatever stage you may be in your tattoo career, apprentice, experienced street shop tattooer, or fully custom artist, it's hard not to feel a little competitive in today's tattoo industry, with so many amazing artists working in all styles in virtually every corner of the world. But you can benefit right now by learning from the experience of the tattoo professionals who have dedicated themselves to education in this industry. I'm Guy Aitchison, and I've been teaching in the tattoo field for much of my 27 years in the trade, with most of my educational efforts being focused within my Reinventing the Tattoo platform, which has been an industry standard in education for nearly two decades. Reinventing was originally conceived as a series of seminars that I held at tattoo conventions, and its curriculum has been filled out and fine-tuned according to the needs of the artists attending these classes. It's now a massive standalone educational package which can be viewed on any kind of device in order to bring the answers you need right to your fingertips. The Reinventing the Tattoo curriculum is centered around a group of fundamental artistic principles of composition, including flow and fit on the body, contrast, positive-negative relationships, color theory, depth, and other concepts, which are framed in a way that is meant to be as useful as possible to working tattoo artists. The material then covers uses of reference imagery and digital tools in your design process, along with a review of alternate art forms such as oils and watercolors and how they can help refine your skills as a tattoo artist. The technical sections are as comprehensive as possible, covering everything from machines and other basic equipment to stenciling and working on various challenging parts of the body. Not only am I sharing everything useful that I know about these subjects, but I'm also enlisting the help of various top-name professionals, such as Russ Abbott, Nick Baxter, Megan Jean Morris, Phil Garcia, Halo Jankowski, and Don McDonald to share their own experience on these topics. You may have already read the book version of Reinventing the Tattoo. However, the new electronic edition has been seriously updated and expanded beyond the scope of the old book, including not only new chapters by myself and our guest writers, but also introducing a massive section on cover-up tattooing, including chapters on lasers and scar cover-ups, plus loads of new video footage to further illustrate the book's topics. Subscribers can look forward to seeing new material added regularly along with further updates to existing content as the Reinventing curriculum continues to expand and evolve. I'd like to invite you to drop by at reinventingthetattoo.com to read more about what we have to offer in the Reinventing the Tattoo educational package. It's the biggest and most detailed teaching effort I've ever been involved with, and I'm completely confident that no matter where you stand in your tattoo career, it can help you to take your work to the next level.
We're back. Sorry about the craziness with the mic being on and making adjustments on the fly and then not really paying attention when we came back. But I mean, after that shot that we just did with everybody, that's what happens. I want to thank everyone for watching. Everyone out there that's listening to the podcast, thank you for downloading it and listening to that. Your live viewers, of course, you guys are awesome. Without you guys, we wouldn't do this show. Next show is going to be Chris Jones and David Corden live from Jiminy Peak, which is where the Paradise Tattoo Gathering is taking place next week. Make sure you get your tickets and come on out and see us in person. It's going to be a blast. Tons of seminars, live music. I don't know. Mountain coaster.
Power coaster.
Cocktails. Beautiful scenery. New England fall. I think it's going to be awesome. Gabe Londis and Josh DeHosa just informed me that there'll be a last minute tequila seminar.
Laura Jade might be a part of that.
If the Jade effect is successful, will also be there. If it's not successful, she's just going to take the seminar. I don't know if she knows that yet, but we'll let her know before next week. I'll be there for sure. The whole shop's going to be there because we're closed. And we want to meet all of you, so come out and see us. Please review our podcast on iTunes. We want to get out there a little bit more. Check out our YouTube channel and subscribe. Also, all of our other social media stuff, Facebook and Instagram and all the stuff the kids are doing these days. I don't know. I'm old. Next show, next Monday. We'll see you then. And until then, thanks for watching. That was chaotic. See ya.
Fuck your beer. Hey, I-